There's an estimate out there that 90% of organizational data is unstructured, meaning it's not in formats like databases where we could easily extract it, but in file types that we're commonly used to working with. Think about things such as PDFs, or for example, DOCX or Microsoft Word, or HTML, right? And that's unfortunate because these file formats don't always play nice with generative AI. That's because when we're using systems that might be working with LLMs, large language models, as well as retrieval augmented generation, or RAG, well, we're able to kind of question and answer over our documents, right? So let's say that we have a question we want to ask about specific enterprise questions, right? And we get that answer back from the RAG system. Well, the answer that we get back and the quality of that answer is highly dependent on the source data that we're using. So how do we ensure that this source data is ready to be used for AI and we're getting the best possible results back from our RAG scenario? Well, let's dive in, because we're not talking just about simple text extraction from our documents here, but commonly encountered situations. A table, for example, might span multiple pages. So we've got page number one here, and then we have page number two here as well, which both combine the same table, right? And this truncation, this page break, can be very difficult to ingest in a RAG system. Or for example, we've got documents that might have some type of image, right? How do we process that and make sure that's effectively used in our RAG system? Or for example, we've got lots of different types of annotations, headers, bullet points, different text that's truncated. These are all situations that OCR would typically struggle with. So when we're trying to process this, you might not get the best results back. Information might be a little bit jumbled. You might have kind of truncated information. And maybe you would like to use some type of cloud system. But if you're working in an environment where you can't send that sensitive data, it might not be an option because of compliance and governance. Or you might also be paying a lot per page in order to process information to get it into your system that's using RAG. So what we're gonna look at today is a open source project that's called Docling. And Docling, what it allows us to do is parse common document formats such as PDFs, right? So working from this source document, we can turn this with Docling into this abstraction, which is a Docling document. This allows us to take and pull different pieces from that source document into one place and be able to export that straight into Markdown or into our RAG integration, such as LangChain or LlamaStack or CrewAI, you name it. So there's a lot of possibilities that we can do once we parse this document. And for developers, there's also a CLI and a library. So I can do a pip install Docling, and what that allows me to do is, say for example, use it in my applications, or maybe serve it as a REST API endpoint, allowing us to automate this document extraction so that we can ingest, for example, reports, contracts, and more with zero reliance on third parties or need for a high-cost GPU and infrastructure. And it's gained a lot of traction on GitHub recently, so let's see how Docling works behind the scenes. So Docling's design is built on three core concepts. And let me explain to you how it works, because whenever you're using Docling via the command line or maybe as a library in your applications or via the API, what's happening in the background is quite interesting. So first off, what begins when you upload a PDF or some type of file format is the parser backend. So we'll come back to this here in a second. But once you've initially read this file, there are the pipelines. So the pipelines are essentially modular and customizable, but they enrich the document representation, extracting more and more information from that initial data source that you provide into a single unified output, which is, as I mentioned before earlier, the Docling document. Now, there's typically two document types that you're going to be working with to process them, to get them ready to use with AI. First are these low-level formats, such as PDFs, right? So PDFs, it's difficult because they're initially made for printing, right? And so maybe it's scanned content as well, but a lot of structure is lost. So if we think about a PDF, right, we can have different types of objects, text, data, maybe this bottom section is a table, right? So Docling, what it initially does is use a custom text and property extractor to be able to tell, hey, what's an object, what's a character, and what's specifically text. And then once that happens, we run through the pipeline in order to do high quality reconstruction. So the first step is what's known as the layout analysis model. So what this does is it essentially goes through and predicts bounding boxes for all of the different page elements like paragraphs, titles. And in addition to that, we're also using another advanced visual model, which is the table former. So table former right here. And table former is able to work with the table structure, the rows, recognition of the columns, all of this logical structure that's really important to keep. And this is what's happening here in the pipeline. And maybe you could even add something like a vision model in order to annotate images, because that's also really important data to have when you're using it with a RAG type of system. Now, let's say we're working with, say for example, a markdown-based type of structure like HTML or DOCX. So we have this same type of file format here. Now, after the parser backend, the pipeline is actually transforming this content, which already has some type of structure, using a few different open source libraries. So for example, you can think of Beautiful Soup, and also Marco, which are essentially transforming this and enriching this document, just as we did with the PDF, into the final output. And the final output here is what's known as the Docling document. So this is the Docling document, and this is a single output, this pydantic data structure that captures the document's full hierarchy. But it also maintains provenance information like the page numbers, geometric locations of content. Let's say that you want to get rid of some PII or something like that. And this structure here is ready to be used for powering your agentic and AI applications. So you could export to Markdown, for example, or JSON. You could directly integrate it into your RAG applications, or you could use that exported data in order to do fine tuning. There's also native integrations with popular developer frameworks, frameworks such as LangChain or maybe Llama Index, that allow us to build advanced RAG pipelines, which enable us to use Docling's hybrid chunker with our structured Docling document information to create one chunk for each individual detected document element. And at the end of the day, that means better and more accurate results in your RAG applications. Now, in the field, Docling was benchmarked against popular open source contenders like Unstructured, Marker, and MinerU with a test of 89 PDF files and 4,000 pages. On both x86 CPU and even the M3 Max, it was the fastest at 1.26 seconds per page to process. That's fast. And you can be fast to check out Docling on GitHub or by going to docling.io. And here you can learn how to install Docling on your system, but also how this Linux Foundation hosted library is processing all types of data conversion and processing, allowing us to build AI applications that tap into the vast organizational and helpful data that can make our lives just a little bit easier. Thanks for watching. If you learned something today, please feel free to hit the like button and subscribe for more content around development and AI. See you again.